Hey folks, let's watch Steve McRae attempt to save face in explaining, without explaining, why he's afraid to debate me.
Yeah, but the other thing came out of it was NephilimFree poked his head out.
I saw that.
You saw that, yeah. So let me tell the people what happens there, because I put a NephilimFree invite out there. I have invited NephilimFree. NephilimFree, for many, many years, has wanted to debate me.
Not specifically. I just challenge all the loudmouth evolutionists in the world. You're one of them. It's not like I'm really desperate to debate Steve McRae. But I have challenged him numerous times.
It'll never happen. I might as well. I would rather debate a second grader on the differences between quantum mechanics, Copenhagen interpretation, or multi-world hypothesis. I mean,
so he's admitting that he's afraid to debate me. He's not, but he is. And then he uses scientific terminology to make it sound like he's so smart that, you know, hey, it wouldn't be anything for me to refute NephilimFree.
There's just nothing I would ever debate NephilimFree on when it comes to these topics. It's just, I might one day say, oh, you know what, I'll debate NephilimFree if he wants to debate 0.998 repeating doesn't equal to 1 or something. Fine. That's math. But anything relating to evolution or science, it's just nothing I have an interest to ever debate him on. However,
well, he doesn't have an interest because he's afraid to debate me. I've engaged with Steve McRae in Google Hangouts a number of times about debate and just literally mopped the floor with him. I asked him questions about his claims. He spent 45 minutes refusing to answer one question one time.
I'll discuss it with him till the cows come home.
Ah, so he'll discuss it in a hangout run by atheists, in which, as is the common experience of all creationists who engage, go into a chat run by and operated by atheists, or evolutionists, rather, I should say. And so he can mute me every time I make a salient point or try to make an argument or query him about a claim he makes. They can just all start talking over you and mute you. And that's the common experience of creationists who debate evolutionists in formats which they operate and run. You go into their hangout, there's four of them, one of you, and when you try to make a salient point, they just shut you off and say, no, that's not true, and start talking over you, mute your mic, and you don't ever get to finish a statement. That's why creationists have shied from going into evolutionist hangouts over the years, is because that tactic. Evolutionists, they'll do it there because they have that tactic where they can mute you and talk over you. But in a structured debate with a moderator, they don't have that available to them, and that's what they fear. That's why Steve McRae and many others like himself are afraid to debate people like me, because they can't talk over you constantly, shut you down, and mute your mic, and prevent you from putting forth evidence that crushes their theory.
But I won't debate him on it, and the reason is this.
Here comes an excuse.
NephilimFree bloviates. NephilimFree doesn't know the topics. He's not worth my time to spend several weeks preparing for a debate, because when I debate...
Yeah, so that's the same excuse as Aaron Raw gives. NephilimFree is not worth my time. But he can make entire videos about me, but I'm not worth his time. Dragging and dropping media into a software application, editing, recording with his mouse, moving files on a timeline, and then, rendering the video and saving it and uploading it. That's worth his time, but engaging in an hour-long, hour-and-a-half-long structured debate with me is not worth his time.
I spent a long time doing it, and it would do no good because the moderator, in my experiences, in every one of his debates, never holds his feet to the fire. They never, ever, ever say, Neffy, this is not proper, or this is not a proper citation. Or
so what he's explaining there is that in formats where the atheists aren't in control of the microphones and everything, and there's four or five or six of them against you, and they don't have the option to shut you down, stop you from talking, and prevent you from providing evidence and arguments against their views, that's called bloviating and not being held to the fire. What he means by not holding your feet to the fire is they don't mute him and talk over him enough like us. And we can't get away with that in a structured debate.
or this is not an argument. They never do anything to hold his feet to fire.
Because this is what evolutionists always do, and formats run by evolutionists. It's very common. It happens a very large percentage of the time, especially for the most outspoken dogmatic evolutionists like Steve McRae, Aaron Ron, whatnot. And it's been my experience in being on all their radio talk shows, their internet talk shows, and debating with them. You start to make a salient point, and you get about 1/4 of the way through it, and you only need 10 or 20 seconds to make a 30 seconds to make a point. Because it's supposed to be a conversation, a debate going back and forth. So, you know, you need 15 or 25 seconds to make a point, but you get 11 seconds, and they mute you and say, no, that's not true. I'm holding you to the fire. Where's the evidence for that? That's not true because so-and-so said that such and such, and that's evidence against it. Blah, 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 blah. And they're going on and on and on after taking the mic away from you or talking over you so that you can't be heard. That's what Steve McRae calls holding somebody's feet to the fire, is we can't shut him down and silence him in such a discussion. And we don't like that because then the audience gets to hear both sides without interruption, without somebody constantly shutting them off. And if the audience hears the evidence, they're not going to believe us. So we have to prevent that from happening. See, this is called damage control, people. It's damage control.
Do right. So I invited him many times to come on here. He's been in here before.
Sure, he wants me to come into his group hangouts where, as I have, and it's the same scenario every time. You know, you get 11 seconds or 9 seconds out of your mouth, maybe you're 15 if you're lucky, and then suddenly there's 3 atheists talking over you. Steve McRae is talking at the top of his lungs. He's muting your mic, and he's going on and on and on. You never got to finish making your statement. Then when he's done, you go back to what you were saying, say, well, let me finish what I was saying. You never let me finish. The point I was making was, and there it comes again. No, time to talk over you, time to mute you. We can't let you make a point. See, that's the common experience of evolutionists, creationists, who go into evolutionist-run formats to have casual debate. And that's the only place that somebody like Steve McRae is willing to debate me, because then they have this tactic at hand where they can mute you and talk over you and prevent you from making a salient point. But they can't get away with that in a structured debate. And that's why he and so many in his camp are afraid to debate me and others like me in a structured, moderated debate.
Before, and every time he's ran away with his tail between his legs.
Oh, yes, I run away from my tail between my legs. I come into his hangout. I try to discuss things, get shut off constantly. Never allowed to finish a salient point, and then frustrated with it after 30 minutes or an hour and a half, and end up leaving, still able to refute him anyway. And that's called putting your tail between your legs and running.
Because he knows I don't let him get away with BS.
Ah, and there it is, you see. He doesn't let me get away with BS. Translation. When he starts to try to make an evidence, put forth an argument for evolution, I just shut him down. I don't let him.
That's why. And so he wants the structured debate because he can bloviate and ramble and gish-gab, gallop and do...
So there it is. You see, he can't prevent me from having a point. Making a point, having an argument, and allowing other people to hear it because they'll see how it refutes the things that he says in a structured debate. That can't be allowed. You see, the outspoken evolutionist camp is a bunch of chickens. They're all afraid, most of them. The loudest ones have a serious following, you know, many thousands of followers on the internet. Those are the guys, like Steve McRae and others, who are afraid to engage in an actual structured debate with a creationist like me, a well-informed one, because it would be damaging to their worldview, to their ego. It would be damaging to their to reputation amongst their many followers. Their followers would see them being refuted by me, and that can't be allowed to happen. And so he's going to misrepresent the way that I discuss things, even in a structured debate, which you won't engage me. He's going to mislabel every argument that I would make as a gish gallop and straw man. It's all so seriously pathetic.
Everything the younger creationist does, which that is not allowed in here, and we have people...
Ah, well, there it is. Not allowed in here. You mean What's not allowed is making a salient point. We can't let you finish that paragraph of words because that would be evidence against my views. You have to shut up.
From all different areas of expertise that can hold his feet to the fire. That is why he's afraid to come in here. And he has to turn that around going, oh, look, Steve's afraid to debate me.
Well, it's obvious who's afraid of who.
Who the hell's afraid of Nephi?
Everybody on the internet except creationists.
Nobody! And yet he clearly thinks that even to this day that I'm literally afraid to debate him. It is the most ridiculous thing in the world that he doesn't grasp this concept of how inept he is.
I'll tell you who's not afraid to debate me or someone like myself. Evolutionists who haven't had their feet burned yet. That's who. Relatively uninformed evolutionists who haven't had their feet burned yet. Those are the ones who are afraid to, not afraid. And they go in against someone who's well-informed, and they get their feet burned, and they learn a lesson that science doesn't support their views, that creation is true. They see the evidence, the arguments, they get refuted, and it infuriates them. Now, there's a few that are really stubborn-headed, and they'll come back for more, you know. But the popular ones, the atheists with a big following, like Steve McRae and others, and Steve's is not as big as some, they can't allow that to happen because that would damage their reputation.
But if he wants to challenge me, by all means!
Well, I have for 10 years, Steve. Well, maybe not 10, 8, 9 now.
Here I am. Come on in.
Only in his format where he can mute me and talk over me, and I'm not allowed to have a say. That's what he's willing to do.
Look like I'm afraid? Do I look? I gave him the link on Skype, so there's certainly nothing to be afraid of.
So, see, I must be afraid to debate him because I won't join his hangouts where, according to my experience and that of many other creationists, is you go in, they mute you, talk over you. Every time you attempt to make a statement, you never get to finish a single statement from start to finish, even if it would only take you 10 or 12, 18 seconds to do it. They can't allow that. And so he's going to disingenuously claim that I'm afraid to debate him in his hangouts while at the same time he has been refusing for 7 or 8 years now to debate me in a structured, moderated debate, a genuine debate. How rich.
I even give him 20 minutes one-on-one with me if he wants.
We've been together in debates and talked more than 20 minutes for 2 hours or three, and it's the same. It's the same. It's the same. You get 11 words out of your mouth, and they start muting you and talking over you. They're just so afraid of you.
But he won't do it. I don't know. He might. He's done it before.
So why should I keep engaging in that practice of entering evolutionist-run hangouts when you never get to finish making a point, and the evolutionists get to make all their points by talking over you and muting you and preventing you from having a say for yourself? What's the point? There just isn't a point in that anymore.
I think it's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while because I decided I was tired of that kind of childish tactic, fear tactic, of being talked over and constantly silenced in a hangout run by atheists or evolutionists where they have control over who gets to say what. It just demonstrates so clearly that you evolutionist camp like yourselves are afraid to debate a well-informed creationist in a structured debate where you don't have the opportunity to silence what they say.
Well, I mean, I don't know if you knew this or not, that you shouldn't be surprised, you know, somebody who runs from a debate, that you are friends with somebody who copies.
Oh, I'm running from a debate. Now, I've had an open challenge to Steve McRae and announced it publicly to debate me in a structured debate for years now. But I'm running from debate from him. Isn't that rich?
Their arguments from Wikipedia.
Oh, that was cold, by the way. I think that was a little...
Yeah, I get my arguments from Wikipedia.
Low blow, by the way, to you. I know you do academic studies. I mean, I firsthand know that. So.
I have no problem screen sharing and showing you my notes, buddy. Like.
Yeah, and by the way, I have nothing against Wikipedia for quick access. I really don't.
And neither do I. But now Steve McRae and his pals here are attempting to misrepresent me by claiming I get all my information from Wikipedia, which is ridiculous. My library of extensive knowledge that I have recorded to my for myself comes from science journals, science journal abstracts, news articles, and talks by scientists, most of them evolutionists, not Wikipedia.
I mean, it's just Wikipedia. If you it's cited properly, it's a quick source to go. Okay, well, here's this. And if people says, well, I don't really think that's right because Wikipedia's not perfect. Then that's fine, right?
It should not be the end all be all. And and if you're not clicking hyperlinks, then there's problems.
So that's terrible behavior. It really is to misrepresent and lie about a creationist claiming that they get all, if not the majority, of their information from Wikipedia, for crying out loud. If someone were to examine the evidences I provided in my videos and in arguments with evolutionists and hangouts and whatnot over the years, I guarantee you'd find that almost everything I say can't be found in Wikipedia.
Yeah, I most when I do use Wikipedia for stuff, I'm always going down to the bottom for the citations. Always.
Mm-hmm.
I always go to the primary sources. If you're using Wikipedia for a debate and you don't go to the primary sources, then you're not doing it right.
Who uses Wikipedia as a primary source for debate?
Yes, because they're taking an entire text and condensing it into a sentence or two and putting a letter behind it.
Exactly. Exactly. So you got to be real careful on that. So nothing wrong with Wikipedia, but you got to understand what you're using it for. It's just basically a very surmised rendition of the primary sources. And you're not going to become an expert on any topic reading Wikipedia. It's not going to happen, especially certain topics like when science, very confusing. Even I will know about a certain topic, and I'll read Wikipedia and go, I wouldn't have written it that way. If I didn't know what the hell they were talking about, no possible way I would have understood this.
Yeah, I don't believe that at all. Steve McRae probably has never thought such a thing while looking at Wikipedia, except unless there's some information in one article that doesn't comport with evolution theory or it's hard to get to work with evolution, and he didn't like it.
So... And I've asked people in their fields, when it comes to Wikipedia, have you seen this with Wikipedia? This it's not really well written, and they're like, yeah, and it's made mistakes. It's again basic concepts. It's not to make you an expert on any particular topic.
Well, true, Wikipedia is a lousy source for truth in science, but he's just grossly misrepresenting things. So there you have it, people. Steve McRae is still, after all these years, still afraid to debate me in a structured debate. Misrepresents the facts to try to save face. Steve, if you see this, the challenge is eternal. If you ever get over the fear of being shown wrong about something in a public format, in a structured debate, you ever gain the courage to come out of your little world of hanging out with other evolutionists and beckoning evolutionists, creationists to come in there so you can talk over them and mute them. If you ever come out of that childish world into the world of real guys who really debate, I'll probably be around.